Hi everyone, welcome. Here we are, session two. I hope you've had a gentle time integrating the initial activation into this Hands of Grace series, and we're ready. We're feeling ready today, ready for the next activation in a little while. There's a bit of preparation that we're going to do in order to ensure that we're ready to receive that in full and can make good use of it. It's interesting, isn't it, that when we start to talk about healing in general, and healing, you know, to alleviate suffering and to be able to take any pain away, you know, whether that's mental, emotional, spiritual, physical, wherever that pain and that suffering is, to alleviate that, to be able to take that away is such a gift. And actually, it's a completely natural thing for us to do. Yet it's kind of been made throughout the history more of something that only some people can do, or you're a bit special if you do it, or you're a bit weird if you do it, or even worse, you know, with some of the collective history that we share, my goodness, it's almost frightening to do it, yeah? And that's the little bit that I'm interested in, because a lot of the times we can get in the way of what is natural to us, what is innate within us, the innate healing wisdom that we're born with. We can get in the way of that because of fear, because of doubt, because of insecurities, but very much because of fear. Now, our bodies are naturally able to heal themselves all the time. They're always trying to find that state of balance. They're always trying to regenerate and restore. And the energies that support our bodies to do that are naturally flowing with us. It's a natural state of being. And yet we only have to look around to see how many people aren't in a state of balance, and that our physical bodies aren't healthy and strong and have found that natural order to regenerate, to heal. And we start to think, why is that? How come if that's what our bodies are designed to naturally do, to heal themselves, then how come there's so much sickness, so many ill people? How come we suffer so much? How come we get so poorly? How come there are all of these diseases that are so rife within humanity right now? We store information, we store historic, cultural, societal, personal narratives and stories within us. And they are like emotional, mental, physical, spiritual blocks. Okay, they're like bits of packets of information that are stored. They're kind of like frozen, they get frozen in time. And so what the body naturally wants to do is to just allow flow, okay? Flow, balance, flow, balance, flow, balance. But what happens is that the information, instead of passing through us, it gets stuck along the way. So a story, for example, something happens to us, we can't let go of it. We're too angry, we become resentful, we feel disempowered, we feel self-righteous, we want that other person to suffer because we've suffered. We now don't want to move on with our lives because we have so much regret. We don't want to move on with our lives because we feel so desperate, there's so much despair, there's sadness, we've been rejected, we feel ashamed. We have a lot of guilt. We don't know what to do about a certain situation, so we keep going round and round and round in our heads about it. And that imprints the physical body over and over again and condenses what should be free-flowing information. It condenses it into packets of energy that can't move. They're data storage energy systems, which should be free-flowing, end up getting blocked with all these packets of unresolved data. Okay, so the energy centers of our bodies are data storage systems. And the energy of the cosmos should be and can be flowing through us all of the time, attuning us to nature's natural cycles and rhythms of regeneration, restoration, change, the rhythms of nature, the cycles of life, etc., etc. And all of that information should be flowing through us all of the time, keeping us in balance, helping us to move forward in a healthy and positive way. And so these vortices are made up of all these vortices of energy. They should be free flowing, but they're not. They become data storage centers for all of the stories that we won't let go of because we're often too scared to. Yeah. We don't want to let go of our anger towards that person that may have upset us, because how are we going to defend ourselves against similar things happening in the future if we don't hold on to that memory of how much it hurt us? Yeah. So we hold on and we hold on and we hold on until we're crippled by stagnant energy, by stagnant old information stuck in our system. Could be any of the systems of the body. Okay. So in order to awaken the healer within, we have to understand that it's a natural way of being. Okay. We're not asking for something new or outside of ourselves. We're attuning to what is innate within us. Something that we're born with, that the body knows how to do naturally. And when provided with the right information, the body can be supported to heal, and that we can just be a natural healer in our lives. But you see, some of the data that's stored within these data storage systems within the body are cultural narratives about how we've been persecuted for having been a healer. Some of the biggest stories that are held and the fears that we hold as human beings are things like the fear of persecution, the fear of suffering on any level. We have a huge, of course, because of the history that we hold, a huge fear of being made to suffer, to being persecuted. But also one of the other big ones, which is going to come up again a lot in this next few years. Well, I may talk about that. But anyway, this is another big one. The fear of being publicly humiliated is massive. It's one of our baseline fears. So people don't want to risk anything. They don't want to put themselves forward. They don't want to be seen. They don't want to be observed in any way as being different. So all the people on the peripheral, you know, anyone with natural abilities for healing and, you know, the witches, the herbalists, the magicians, all of these kind of archetypal energies, which are important patterns within our human psyche, all of those are kind of on the peripheral. They're not invited into humanity's vision for holism. Yeah, because of the data that is held, the historic information of persecution and betrayal and shame and rejection that those kind of archetypes hold. It's big. It's a lot to get your head around, okay? And I could go into it with more detail. We're going to do a meditation about it just to help you to connect with that part of you, which I think is the most important thing we can do. But just to be aware as well that this is an awakening within the human consciousness, that all of those that are on the peripheral, yeah, those that have been marginalized in all of these different ways, yeah, they're the ones that we need to integrate into holism the most. That's where the magic is. That's where the lost information is of how we can create a more sustainable way of being. We can't just reject parts of who we are and expect that everything's going to be okay. Yeah, particularly when we're rejecting parts of who we are that help to keep us in alignment, that help to keep us healthy, that give us strength and power. There are huge grids of power that are here to support us, but if we disconnect from them, then we're left in a state of confusion, in a state of overwhelm, in a state of not knowing who we are, in a state of not belonging. Yeah, belonging's really, really important. And so if you're outcast, if you're on the peripheral, if you don't quite fit in, if you were the black sheep in your family, yeah, all of that has to be integrated into the whole now, because we have to. It is inevitable that we recognize that a holistic way of being is a natural state, and that that's where health, healing, equilibrium, sustainability, connection to each other, connection through the natural systems and order of universal consciousness, where all of that starts to play out and get grounded into a new way of being. All of that has to be integrated. We have to experience who we really, really are. And so let's just do a little meditation to start with on the healer within you. Let's get a connection to that, and we'll start to get an understanding of what we need to do. Okay. Take a moment now just to breathe into this space. And if you haven't done so already, then this is the time to close your eyes. And should you wish to, you can experience an insightful inner journey. Focus on your breathing. Breathing in relaxation. Breathing out any tension. Breathe in and allow your focus to be on taking in this moment. A moment of presence. A moment of awareness of your sacred self. As you breathe, allow the breath to transport you, taking you to a deeper, more purposeful part of yourself, who knows exactly what you need to do to relax fully and enjoy this time of introspection. You are connecting more deeply with yourself, more deeply now than perhaps ever before. This journey is an invitation to travel deep, deep, deep within your beautiful self. To a place of power, perhaps a place where power has been lost, or maybe a place where true power might be gained, a place where you can know yourself more fully, love yourself for being you, and accept whatever you sense with gratitude, kind forgiveness, and compassion for your beautiful, beautiful self. You've been through so much. You must have compassion for yourself now, and the journey, for how it's been. We have collectively and historically been through a great deal as human beings, and we bear the scars of this journey in our psychic energy field and in our collective and ancestral memory. We indeed still carry the wounds of more savage times, where the sages and the seers and the healers and the mystics were shamed, humiliated, destroyed. We're here to collectively heal this trauma. Our vulnerability is sensed within these painful wounds, and our power is held like a prisoner behind these walls. And it takes great courage to look beyond this and see the truth which must be revealed. The time has come to enter into a new phase of our human evolution. Those who have been shut out, closed down, silenced, and feared for the truth they speak and the power they hold in their hearts, and who've been marginalized or made scapegoats, who've been ridiculed and judged by those who have agendas which do not serve our greater collective evolution and all our planet's natural laws and order. The new phase has begun, and you are called. It's time to remember and to take back our power and move into a new level of awakened presence where our multisensory awareness is acknowledged and experienced in full. And our sacred lives are lived in humble appreciation of the interconnectedness of all life. Breathe. Take a moment to tune into the parts of yourself who are on the peripheral, outside the norm, those aspects of yourself who sense more, who have a bigger or deeper awareness of things. The wisdom keeper, the poet, the artist, the musician, the magician, the witch, the herbalist, the one who senses through more senses than others and who longs to share the magic of their soul, but is wary to do so. For who knows what might happen if that inner magic, that inner truth is revealed and or seen. Breathe and know that all these aspects and more, and you'll have a sense of your own. They're all here to guide the awakening process, to express themselves and support your journey. But some may not feel so comfortable right now. Some may feel they are not welcome, not wanted, not needed. And so just gently let your heart, the energy of your heart, surround them. Allow grace to pour into them. Without judgment, without fear. Though you may sense the judgment and fear and the patterns they hold dissolving, and you can witness that. But imagine breathing together in a moment of connection, celebration, and peace. You can imagine that you create a circle of light. Join hands with as many aspects of your most magical nature as you can. Imagine all holding hands, creating a circle of light together. A moment of appreciation for what it feels like to be together in light. You can imagine another bigger circle of light surrounding you all, creating a sacred circle, held by the Earth herself, holding you in her gravitational embrace, helping you to acknowledge and deeply embrace the true magic of you, calling you to be at one with her natural cycles and rhythms. And then imagine an even larger circle, encircling those circles. This powerful circle holds the light of the cosmos, the heart of the galaxy, reminding you of your infinite relationship with the unseen and uncharted realms. Simply breathe in this circle of light. This is a sacred circle, a powerful circle. This is where grace can flow. Feel the strength and power of this circle. And you imagine yourself stepping forward into the center of the circle and light, grace beaming down into you. You invite the healer within you to enter the circle with you. Call to the healer within to enter this sacred space here and now. Allow the power of grace to flow in to the healer within. You and the healer within in this sacred circle of light, supported by the earth, supported by the cosmos. Just breathe into this space. This is a powerful moment of self-discovery, self-awareness, and deep, deep self-inquiry. Take all the time you need to witness the healer part of yourself. You can ask that more and more grace is poured into your healer self, this healer aspect, the healer within you. You can ask that all the scars are healed, all the trauma removed, and the power you once lost, no matter from when or where or how, or what stories are recalled or held. This true power is now returned to you in full. You are witness to this. This is a powerful and magical moment. You look into the eyes of your healer self and you say from your heart how sorry you are for all that has gone on before, for all that may go on in the future, and that you're now ready to embrace this new phase and create a new empowered world where your healer self will be accepted and where the wisdom within can be acknowledged. channeled appropriately. Let that sorry from your heart echo out throughout this great holographic matrix of light. Where any information is held, all can be healed now. All can be transmuted. All can be released. Breathe with your healer self. Breathe together until you merge together as one. Let the power of grace move through you, uniting you in a purposeful and sacred journey. Your destiny opening up to you now. Take all the time you need to integrate this powerful process. There really is no hurry. You can take all the time you need. And when you're ready, you can open your eyes. Okay, great. Awakening all of these parts of ourselves is so important, but particularly for this Hands of Grace series, then the healer within you. I often meet people that work as a healer, yet their healer self hasn't been integrated properly at all. It takes time sometimes. And sometimes what it means is that they're using their own energy. They're not channeling grace. They're not opened to receive because they've got blockages in their own energy system. And so they're working from a place of often powerlessness. And so they can sometimes become very ill themselves, even though they're working as a healer and trying to help other people. And it's out of balance. It's out of balance. Rather than healing themselves and truly awakening the healer within them to be in balance and available and awake, they want to solve the problems of other people. They want to heal someone else. And that usually comes down to unresolved issues of self-worth and not valuing oneself in full. And trying to have perceived value in the eyes of others as a healer or somebody of power or someone that's helpful or someone that can help. And the most important person that you need to help first, it's like that oxygen mask thing, you know, you've got to put your own mask on first. Yeah, you have to, well, you don't have to, you do what you like, but you would be advised to, or it is better to, make sure that you yourself are in as clear and balanced place as possible. And that when you can start really healing yourself and opening up to the healer within you, yeah, then things start to become very soft, very fluid, very natural very easy, very balanced and in the flow, which is what you want. You want to be in the flow. So we're going to go into activation number two. So similarly to activation one, just going to place your hands like this. You'll close your eyes. And then when you feel ready to, you'll place your hands out like this. Okay. And then at some point, they'll just feel like they want to come back together like that. Bring them into your heart like that. And then like this. Okay. Okay. So when you feel ready, you can close your eyes and get ready to receive activation too. All the time you need. Just let that energy settle. And when you feel ready, you can open your eyes. It's really about a return to power, you know, this whole next phase, giving away a lot of power. We still give away a lot of power. The stories, the narratives that we currently hold engage us in power struggles. And so we're going to softly, gently ensure that we disentangle ourselves from such power struggles and become empowered in who we are. And in what we do, okay, and that does mean becoming comfortable with who we are, and that can take time, and it can take as long as it needs to take. There can be a lot of layers to that, but it's the center of everything in a way. You have to be in your own power, yeah. And it's the journey of now. The energies are here to support you in that now. And maybe that hasn't been the case before. But now that is so. And so as you become more aware of the power struggles that you have, where you lose power, who you are when you're in your power, how that feels, the sacredness of that inner power that you have, and how important it is for that inner power, that inner light, to have a space to be, to shine through, and to bring that power into your life, into your day-to-day life, in whatever way is right for you. And so an awakening to power, it's all part of this journey. And connecting to your healer self and your natural healing abilities and the power you have in your physical body to heal. It's incredible. You start to unlock that softly, softly. Okay. I'm going to take you through those hand positions. for self-healing. And each time I'll give you a little bit more information about that. It's always nice to open your session with a prayer. And because the vortices of your palms have been activated, then placing your palms together just brings extra energy from your heart connection to your hands through your palms into that prayer, into that focus of your attention. And you can set your intention or just say a prayer, whatever feels right for you. It may just be a little something like, I open my heart to the flow of energy here today. May I be blessed with balance in my body, in my mind, in my life, in my emotions, in my spirit. Thank you. Whatever works for you. And as you connect in like that, can then take those energetic vortices in the palms of your hand and put them on top of your shoulders. It's your first position, top of shoulders. Now as we go through the sessions, I'll give you more information about what all these positions are for and what they do, but we'll just go through them just very briefly today. Just so you can get used to moving your hands into position and start to create some muscle memory for that. So from that first position on the top of your shoulders, and then move to the back of your head. Just cradling your head in the palms of your hands. You can do 3 minutes for each session, for each movement, for each position. And then you can move your hands into the third position, which includes your eyes, your brow, your temples. So it's kind of like you just allow the tips of your fingers to settle on your brow, and you're cupping your eyes. So it includes your eyes, your third eye, and your temples at the side. And these beams that are coming out of your hands, they're large, you know, so they do cover quite a large area. And the fourth position, you move down to your ears and just gently cover your ears with your hands. And then the fifth position, you can move to your jaw and your throat. And just let your little fingers run along the edge of your jaw there and just beam that energy into your throat area. There's often a lot of tension held around the jaw area and the mouth area, so this can start to help to release that. And then the sixth position, you can move your hands down to your heart. And then on down, position number 7, to your solar plexus. It's like the little upside down V that's in between your ribs. And some people are smaller across that area than others, and so you can either have your hands positioned as mine are there, or if your fingers cross over a bit because you're slight, then that's okay as well. Whatever feels more comfortable, really. And that's the same with your sacral, position 8, as you move down just below your belly button. That position there. My hands always tend to kind of drop down a little bit there. It almost creates a little V shape between my thumbs and my fingers. But the more you'll do this, the more you'll sense what's right for your own body, you'll get a greater feeling of the energy working with you, and you'll relax more into it, start trusting your intuitive flow. These are just the positions to give you a framework of reference just to start with. Okay, and then from the sacral, move down to position 9, which is the base. Now this energy vortex moves downwards. So you kind of beam the energy down between your legs. If you can imagine that beam of energy going right down to the ground. And your knees. Well, you can either put your hands, one hand on each knee, or you can do the front and back of it, one knee, and then the front and back of the other knee. And you're going to do your both your feet, which again you can do by just placing your hands on the top of your foot and then underneath your foot, the bottoms of your feet. Or you can do them one at a time, where you put your hand on the top of your foot and the bottom of your foot at the same time, as I'm doing here, and then the other foot, hand on the top, hand on the bottom. See what works for you and what's most comfortable. And it doesn't really matter so much what order you do them. You know, you don't need to do the left knee and then the right knee, or either way round. You know, it's okay. They're kind of all connected, those energy centers anyway, and they can all be worked on together, which you'll see as we carry on. And so you do the knees and the feet. And then the back of your base. Again, that energy is beaming out, as if it's beaming out of your bottom, out of your coccyx, down your spine and out into the ground, going down between your legs. And so it depends, I guess, how you're doing this, whether you're sitting in a chair, whether you're lying down, or whether you stand up. And you may try all different ways of doing it and different things at different times. And you'll start to find what works for you. You know, sometimes there are positions and you think, oh gosh, you know, that's much easier if I just lie on my side and do that position, for example, or put my legs, you know, up a little bit if I'm lying down. And so just find what works for you. But the idea there is to just connect to the back of the base and beam the energy down there. And then you're going to move. Position 15 is to the back of the sacral. So it's the back of that area where you were just below your belly button. You're now just reaching behind to do that one. And then up a little bit to the solar plexus. Again, the back of the position that you've already done, where that upside down V is in your ribs. You're kind of at the back of there with the solar plexus position. And again, find a comfortable way to do this. You know, the energy is intelligent, and so if you can't quite reach to that position, maybe you've had an injury, or you're not able to quite get into a position for the full 3 minutes, for example, then just know and trust that the energy will find its way, so long as that's what you're intending, so long as you're clear in what you're doing. You've got that awareness that the energy is coming out of the palms of your hands and it's going to the back of the solar plexus. And it will find its way there. And with the back of the heart, Some people can reach around to the back of their heart, but it's just so nice to give yourself a hug. So I just give myself a hug. And I might cross my arms the other way as well and just do, you know, a minute and a half hugging that way and then that way. But whatever works for you. Again, it's that attention to or intention of placing the palms of your hands or allowing the energy that's coming through the palms of your hands to go into the vortex at the back of your heart. And then the last position, number 18, you're going to bring your hands to the front and you're going to cross your arms. And then the palms of your hands go on your clavicle, like your collarbone. There's a point around there, either side there. This is an important position. You'll have a specific activation for this towards the end of our sessions. And so allow the energy just to flow into that position for 3 minutes. And then when you've finished that and you're feeling all relaxed, just bring your palms back into prayer position and just give thanks. Thanks to your body for receiving that. Thanks to the energy of the universe pouring through you. Whatever you'd like to be grateful for in this moment. Okay, great. So our third session, we will be looking at the physical body. Okay, we'll be looking at the systems and the organs and the physical implications of stuck energy and how to start to move energies through the systems of the body to bring greater vitality and to resolve any of those health issues that are showing up for you. And to give you really a clear idea of just how important the energy of the energy flowing through your body is to support the regenerating processes. And this next session three, is quite jam-packed. I think you're going to get a lot from it. So I look forward to sharing that with you. Make sure you take good care of your beautiful self. It's another big process today as you integrate this second activation. And so drink some water, give yourself lots of nourishment in whatever way is right for you. And if you have any questions or any comments, then please write them below on the YouTube channel, especially if you've got things that you'd like to share with me that I'd love to hear about and with others that are tuned into this series, because together we're stronger.